So, Dave, did you ever think we'd see this?
I don't know, man. Our early stuff was pretty bad. I wasn't so sure this was possible.
Well, we did get better.
And we did keep trying to improve.
I think it's only fair that we mention the other YouTubers that helped us get to where we are by pushing the boundaries of what a good D&D YouTube channel looks like.
It's a great idea, Ted. Let's talk about Nerdarchy's top YouTubers for D&D. Welcome to Nerdarchy. I'm Nerdarchus Dave, and as usual, I'm hanging out with this nerd.
Nerdarchus Ted.
You know, sometimes your favorite YouTubers just don't have a new video up, and you really want to watch a D&D video.
Well, if you hit that subscribe button, you're going to keep seeing those D&D content videos coming straight towards you.
Also, don't forget to hit that notification bell so you don't miss a single video. Before we jump into this video, let us do a quick shout out to our sponsor. They've got a Kickstarter going on right now. It hit over $1 million in the first 12 hours. It's phenomenal. It's insane. I'm loving this Kickstarter for Hero Forge 2.0. Like, Hero Forge was also already an amazing site for people like Ted who like to paint minis. I hate it. I don't actually enjoy painting minis, but I do love having a custom, fully colored mini that now you can get printed from Hero Forge. These things look fantastic. They look like they've been painted by professional painters.
We've actually been lucky enough to see a prototype even before the Kickstarter released. And when I opened it up and saw it the first time, I honestly thought it was a painted mini. And the stuff is looking fantastic. All of the customization options from Hero Forge and their expansive library of options are all there. Now they're adding essentially a paint feature. It's going to be color printed at the specs of your choosing. They've already unlocked amazing stretch goals like animal prints for your animalistic minis. You've got
war paint,
blood and mud spatters. You've got makeup that you can put on them. You know the characters can have earrings. There's so many more options.
Did you want high heels? You can have high heels.
They just keep unlocking more and more stretch goals, which is only increasing the ever-expanding arsenal of the customization process of Hero Forge. They were the first to really do this and do it well. And I gotta say that, you know, it's why it's my favorite customizable mini creation process. So you gotta check it out. The link for the Kickstarter is gonna be down there. You gotta check it out.
All right, so we're going to go over Nerdarchy's top YouTubers. They're not in a particular order. We're not ranking them. We have some categories that, you know, why we like these particular creators for you to check out. We know we're probably going to miss some of your favorites, so feel free to help us out, help the community out. Put them in the comments. Let us know which YouTube channels you're watching. And if you haven't checked out these, we highly recommend that you do.
I just recommend if you're going to, you know, put them in the comments, don't use a link or YouTube is going to mark it as spam. So just, you know, put the name and allow the fellow YouTube users to just go put that in their search bar.
So first up, we have our conversational Dungeons and Dragons creators. I feel like we actually kind of pioneered this one. But we're not on the list. WebDM, they're the ones that actually pushed us the most. They came on the scene with a fantastic physical set, high production values, and showed us what doing a YouTube video could really be like. They came on like a year after us, and we've been able to make friends with them and meet them in conventions and play games with them, which has been phenomenal. But also there's some others that have come up recently and are doing a fantastic job.
And that's going to be Dungeon Dudes. They've got the same conversational tone that WebDM and ourselves, you know, kind of fit into, like everybody, or not everybody, I don't want to, you know, throw that out there, but like so many, you know, gaming YouTubers, they've got the matching beards, it fits in, it feels like there's that extra camaraderie when I see that kind of stuff, you watch it, and they've got, you know, a nice level speaking voice, and it just kind of lulls you in and be like, how much time has passed while watching these guys?
Like the siren song.
Almost. So I, you know, definitely enjoy watching their videos.
The next category I'm calling the D&D scholar.
So first up, we have Matt Colville. And, you know, this guy has got an amazing, presence already before he started doing YouTube. And when I first started watching his videos, and I'm sorry to say it, I didn't particularly care for it. It was very close in on his face. He didn't blink. And it was, it, for me personally, it was a little bit off-putting. His newer videos have gone away from that. And I find that, you know, I've taken a lot of lessons specifically from that. We've actually done a handful of videos or had some video idea talk based on some of those. And that was from me watching to say, hey, I saw this video. What do you think about this as a topic? So definitely recommend, checking out his channel.
Another one is Monarch Factory, Dal Kingsman. She's great. She's awesome. She does a lot of different things with folklore and is very much, it kind of reminds me of Matt Colville style a little bit with her own spin on it. And she's also a Australian YouTuber.
Yeah, I've seen a handful of her videos. Again, it's another one of those, talking head videos that it draws you in, and she really knows what she's talking about, and she projects confidence when she's recording. So definitely got to check her out.
Next up, we have our animated D&D. I feel like this is like newer into the space, but it is catching wildfire all over the place. So Puffin Forest is one of the first ones to really blow up. Ben is a great guy. We've met him a couple times, out and about. He even played in one of the live streams games that we did early on.
Mm-hmm.
And then also Z Bashaw, Animated Spellbook. Most of these people actually we've had on our channel at one time or another when we used to do the live chats. Z by far is my favorite animator. He does not have the most subscribers like some of the other ones, but he's actually a professional animator and has done commercials like Red Bull. Red Bull gives you wings. He's done the animation and that stuff. And I think that his actual animations are the best out there.
I couldn't pick a favorite between, Ben from Puffin Forest or Z's videos. I enjoy them both. They're very entertaining. All of them have that, because they're animated. You've got shorter clips, so it's definitely enjoyable to watch, and you can go through multiple videos and quickly. I watched a handful of the animated spellbook, my favorite being the help action, because it's, quite comical in the way he delivers it, so definitely recommend you check out both of them.
Yes. Also, I want to add one more to that, and as Dingo Doodles, she does great animation as well. Her stories are funny and catchy. Also really good and worth checking out.
So our next category is Best D&D Advice. And for this one, we've got How to Be a Great Game Master. We've got Guy. Again, this is someone that we've met in person. Of the lot, I think his voice is one that has drawn me in for his videos. The most recent video that I saw was the one about rights, and there's a lot of fantastic information, to say that it's not about what it is that you're doing, it's about what the character, can take away, which I think is fantastic. And the rest of his videos fall in that same vein. As the name of the channel implies, he's giving you advice to be a better game master.
He also does player advice as well. His videos tend to be a little more generic, so it's not necessarily specifically D&D, but oftentimes he'll talk about D&D as well. I've gotten the chance to play with Guy in games, and both as a fellow player and as him with being the dungeon master. There is a reason why his channel is How to Be a Great Game Master. Next up is Seth Skorkowski. Hopefully I'm not butchering that too bad. Also got to meet Seth at Gen Con this year. Seth is a great content creator. He's also a writer. His videos are very informative. He does a lot of reviews in addition to, videos that help you as a player and as a game master. And, not only that, he does these funny skits where he does a bunch of different characters. And, he plays them all, which is a lot of fun as well. And like I said, we got to meet him, which was really cool at Gen Con. Check out his channel for sure.
It's awesome when we get to, meet the fellow YouTubers. So that's another great thing about going to conventions is you'll get to see these kinds of people. So our next category is most entertaining D&D creators.
All right. These are folks that I don't feel like I learn much when I go there, but I laugh a lot and I really have a good time at their channels. There is information in there, but their videos tend to be shorter and a bit more visual, especially RuneSmith and Davy Chappies, which both of are fantastic channels, great YouTubers, great guys. And then there's also the XP to level 3, Jacob. Now, the really cool thing about all three of these, they're actually like all in their early 20s, right? So it's like watching the next generation come up and like, you know, passing the torch. And they are all phenomenal. XP to level 3 was the first of the three. And Runesmith, actually, Logan was on XP to level 3. They decided that they should have their own channels. And, you know, they were roommates and good friends and everything. And Runesmith blew up overnight like that. You know, Jacob, you know, supported his channel, helped him get a leg up. And now, like, Runesmith has passed everyone out there. But you know what? All three of them have, like, great entertaining speaking voices. They're fun. And they're just really enjoyable to watch, you know, while you're learning about D&D.
Yeah, so if you're looking to learn and laugh at the same time, there are channels you got to check out. So our last category, this is, you know, falls into more of my realm of interest and I dare say expertise, informational content on crafting, D&D crafting YouTubers or RPG crafting YouTubers. We've got three here. I've met and gamed regularly with two of them. So we have Jeremy from Black Magic Craft. He's, you know, really informational. His videos are really tight and awesome. We have Scotty from DM Scotty, you know, the craft father, if you will. And then we have V from the Crafting Muse. All of their videos are incredibly informative, instructional. I've watched and used a variety of their different videos. You know, it's something that I, as a novice crafter, I want to learn and do more. And each of their videos, each of their channels is ways to say, oh, well, I want to take this and learn how to paint it. Or I want to take this and take, you know, just the craft kind of stuff that I can pick up down the street and be able to make cool terrain or cool objects, you know, or monsters for, you know, for my D&D game. I recall specifically a Sturge video that DM Scotty had made, and he showed you how to take toothpicks and, you know, turn them into Sturges with just, craft plants and some hot glue. And my players were slightly terrified when I put 20 Sturges on the board. And it was, you know, cost pennies to make them. So
now I am not a huge crafter myself, but when I watch any of these folks make stuff, it's like witchcraft or sorcery. It's amazing what they can do. Jeremy Pillipow may very well be one of the first, not just crafter channels, but D&D channels to hit over 200,000. You know, not counting like Matt Colville and Critical Role, those and the animators. Those folks are all in their league of their own. But if he isn't there already, he's super close. And I got to play in a Saber Dice game with Jeremy. Torg was a fun blast to play with. I've played with DM Scotty. I don't think I've actually played with any games with V yet, but you know that'll probably change in the near future. So all of them are amazing. Every YouTuber on this list is amazing. You should definitely check them out. We will put links in the description to all their channels. You'll be able to easily find them. If you like listening to us gab about our favorite YouTubers, here is a video response we did to Matt Colville. D&D House Rules, Stealing Villains Actions. There's going to be a card around here somewhere that you can click and open up and check that out.
Speaking of D&D YouTubers, did you know that these YouTubers create custom D&D content every month?
We also do weekly patron live chats and monthly giveaways that our patrons are automatically entered in, and more.
So until next time, stay nerdy.